in the game.
Ah, more sports games. My favourites. That last statement wasn't necessarily true. Hi guys, it's Mike here, One Go Short Play, and today we are playing Australian Rugby League for the Sega Mega Drive. Now, is Australian Rugby League Australian Rules Football, or is that something else? Is Australian Rugby League Rugby League? I think it is, isn't it? Now, despite going to school in Widnes, which is a big rugby town, I am from Liverpool, and I know nothing about rugby to this day. I was very fast when it came to rugby, but I do remember my first... Oh, no way. I do remember my first go at rugby. Let's go for a short game. My first go at rugby at school. I ran down the pitch. I left everyone behind. And then I threw the ball at the floor in like a little celebratory dance. And they all went, "What are you doing?" Because you're not meant to do that. And I didn't know. That was my first experience of rugby. I was like 12 or 13 years old, and I'd never played rugby before. No, oh, I remember this. I had this on cart for a while for the Mega Drive. I got a Mega Drive recently off a mate of mine, Big G, and yeah, he gave me a load of games with it, and this was one of them. And I did swap it at the retro shop for something that I liked more, despite it being built on. Basically the FIFA engine, isn't it? Oh, it looks very close to it. I'm guessing if I hit buttons randomly for a bit, I'll start to figure out what they do. Okay, I'm the guys in white and red, I think. Or am I? Oh, no, I'm not. No, I am. Okay, B button selects your player. I'm guessing A button sprints if you haven't got the ball, like in FIFA. No, it doesn't. It doesn't. Oh, and is that me with the ball? I don't know what I did there. Now, this is like I remember the blur. Let's start again. This is how I remember this game playing out when I first played it. Yeah, a bit like this. When I played it and then took it to the retro shop and swapped it for something else. Because really, that doesn't happen in rugby unless one team is particularly bad and getting owned. played rugby in school, didn't really pick up the rules, just figured out that you have to run down the pitch, dodge everyone, get the ball onto the floor without dropping it, and then, I don't even remember doing that ever, and that thing where you stand in a line on the side of the pitch and someone throws the ball in and you all jump up on each other and grab it, I can't remember doing that. I'm sure we did do that though. What I do remember is scrums and football boots on like your hands and stuff. Oh man, the pain. It was painful. But it was one of those things you just kind of get on with it. I didn't want to do that, did I? That's it. Kick that ball wherever it's going randomly into another player, enemy player's hands. Right, I'm going to actually make a concerted effort now to knock him down and take the ball off him. Did I do it? Get the ball, kick him. No, that's not happening, is it? Yeah, I know that's not how you play rugby. I do know that much. I just remember being quite fast and occasionally getting caught out. And you tend to get hurt around the ears. That whole cauliflower ears thing. I remember that being a particularly painful spot. Cauliflower ears, or pain in your ears, like you being sort of, I don't know, someone's knee in your earlobe, you know, that's, or kind of around your ear, the flappy bit of your ear. Just elbows and knees against your ear, like hard. That happened a lot. And, oh, it's a scrum, hit buttons, throw ball, where's that going, I didn't do that, sorry, that only dogs can hear me now, get him, kick him, over, no, it's not happening, yeah, and another memory of rugby that really, really stands out is that feeling, I don't know if anyone else shares that feeling, this might be, not be something we share at all, that feeling when, you come in from the rugby pitch and you... Oh, is that me? That's me. Oh, go the other way. Oh, no, they're all moving in on me. What do I do? Faster than this. Oh, no, that's not good. It was like running underwater. Okay, have I got the ball now? Don't kick it. Push. What am I trying to say? Throw it. That's the word. Throw it. Oh, yeah, okay, so I think B throws it. What? No, B jumps to the floor. Yeah, coming in. Oh, be does throw it. We're away. Let's go. Sprint forward. What are you doing? What's that about? You won't go forward. Yeah, coming in to the changing rooms, putting your school uniform back on, and not having enough dexterity in your fingers to do your tie because they're so cold. And there's nothing more, but there's probably little more at that moment frustrating than not being able to fasten your tie because of cold fingers. It's really quite a scary experience the first time it happens. And it's one of those outstanding memories from when I was a kid. Really, well, stands out. Check that out. And randomly just made about a yard forward there. Yeah, it really stands out for me. And that's one of those horrible... Oh, rugby was horrible. I hated rugby. I hated sports. Although I was strangely sporty, despite my loathing of sports. I was one of those kids who liked the art rooms, the solace of the art rooms. I spent my lunchtime drawing stuff, which is pretty much what I do for a job. But yeah, totally off on a tangent there. This game, I don't like it, but that might be because I don't like rugby, and I don't get it. You can probably tell I don't get it. I'm just kind of trying to push forward, although moving forward in this game is like running through treacle. And it's all you can see. It's all very floaty. It looks like it's built on the early FIFA engine, which is good for football, but really not for this particular rugby game. That is the end of the match, and that is the end of the video. I didn't like it. It went straight back to the retro shop. I would never buy it. It's one of those. I think my brother bought FIFA, and we got well into that, the original FIFA. And FIFA 95, was it? You know, they were brilliant. Isometric footy game. Very, very well designed when you consider everything that came before was basically side on or top down. The isometric model should have translated quite easily to a rugby game, but I felt it didn't in this case. It just wasn't very good. That's my opinion. It may be wrong. You may love rugby and you may love this game and you've probably got history with it and you're probably screaming at your screen right now. But for me, nah. Australian Rugby League, Sega Mega Drive, thanks for watching.